What's up, everyone? This is CyberKnight8610, and today we have a cool new opening for you guys, and that is a Yu-Gi-Oh! Art 5 20th Legendary Collection for you guys. Yes, this is the Legendary Collection for Japan. It's a little bit different. It's weird that it's called that because it really has nothing to do with Legendary Collections. It's not like what we've seen. You know, we've had, like, I guess 5 different Legendary Collections with Joey's World and 5Ds and all the other stuff that come out for us, and they're in a box, and you get mega packs and stuff. Well, this is something that came out for Japan in their V-Jump magazine, which is Shonen Jump magazine, and it has 5 promo cards in it. It's the promo cards we talked about before, so you're getting the same 5 cards no matter what you get in this pack. But yeah, I just thought it was kind of funny. It's called Legendary Collection because it's not what I picture for a Legendary Collection. So yeah, this, of course, is from Japan, and I got this from Jockera.com, so be sure to check them out. Link in the description. But anyway, let's see what we get here. Like I said, you're guaranteed the same cards, but I still wanted to get this because there's a lot of really awesome cards in this. Alright, here we go. The first one we have is Red Eyes Tracer Dragon. This is the new Red Eye support. So, and also in this pack, every series is getting their own cards. This is, of course, the one that's kind of for the original series, so new Red Eye support, and it's a really good card, too. Then after that, going on to basically GX, we have a new Master Hero, which is Master Hero Blast. Only complaint is we need a new Wind Hero, not Master Hero, I guess, just regular Elemental Hero, because without Stratos, and I guess really the only option we really have is Avion, we need another one to make sure you can use this card a little easier. Avion, unfortunately, is not the best one to use, which I hate saying that because it's like my favorite original Elemental Hero, but yeah, we need another Elemental Hero that's Wind. Hopefully they'll do that at some point, or give a Stratos back, one or the other. I'm fine with either. Then after that, we have the Divine Spark Dragon Stardust. This is Yusei's new card. This is all from the manga, too. All different cards from, I guess, except for, technically, Red Ice, because, yeah, that wasn't in the original series. But there you go. It's basically like the Quasar that he has in the manga, and it's a really good card, too. It looks amazing. Probably the coolest artwork out of all of them. Then, of course, we gotta have a new form to Utopia. So we have number S0 Hope Zexel, or Zell, whatever you prefer on pronunciation. And also, I guess it could be called number S0 Utopia, you know, instead of Hope, because Utopia and Hope, you know, that's what it's called in Japan, is Hope instead of Utopia. So there you go. But yeah, this is probably one of the best cards from the set, too. It's amazing. It has like a cold wave built into it. And can't wait for this to get printed over here, because I want to build a deck around Utopia using this card. And we also still need that manga promo, too. So hopefully we'll get those pretty soon, around the same time. And then the last one we have is, I guess, the one for Yuya, and that is Oversight Magician. It looks pretty cool. It's a new Pendulum Monster, and really cool artwork on it, too. So it's a pretty interesting card. I guess it's going to be for the Arc 5 manga. Like I've said before, I don't think anything's been really announced on that yet, or that I've heard of. So yeah, there you go. Here are all the cards you're going to get in this pack. Look awesome. I mean, like, every card's good from this. I wish we would just get a pack like this like Japan does. Unfortunately, you won't see something like this over here in English, in the TCG. We'll probably get these, like, added to our packs or something. You know, they'll be thrown in some kind of pack for us. Hopefully Tracer Dragon will be added, you know, really soon. You know, we can get that in August and everything, too, because all the Red Eye support's coming out in August. So yeah, can't wait for these. Looking forward to them. Like I said, they'll probably just be added in, like, the next couple of sets. We'll probably start seeing these. And the main one I'm most sad about is the Utopia form, though, because I can't wait to build something around all the different Utopia forms. And there's, I guess, is there 8 Utopia forms or more than that, I think, now? So yeah, can't wait for that. But yeah, tell me what you guys think about these cards. Which one is your favorite out of all of them? And can't wait until we get these over here in the TCG. As always, thank you guys for watching. Make sure to comment, rate, and subscribe. And of course, I will catch you guys later. See ya.
Hope you guys have enjoyed my latest video. Be sure to subscribe for more Yu-Gi-Oh! Videos, as well as check out my other two channels, CyberKnight Games for Let's Plays, and also CyberKnight CCG for Cardfight Vanguard openings. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you guys later. See ya.